Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our literature class. Before we begin today's lesson, we shall have a short recall of what was taught last day. Last day we have seen how Bassanio, in spite of the request made by Portia to wait, does not want to wait. He wants to make his choice immediately. But before he goes to make the choice, Portia warns him, saying, "I am locked up in one of the caskets, and if you make the right choice, I'll be yours." Then she says that if you make the wrong choice, it will be like that of a swan's death. If you make the right choice, it will be either like a newly crowned monarch being welcomed with trumpet, or like a bridegroom who is woken up early in the morning of the marriage by a sweet music. Then she further explains that Bassanio is the Hercules who saved the prince of Troy from the sea monsters. Similarly, Bassanio will save Portia now. She adds, saying that Bassanio is greater than Hercules because Hercules was motivated by physical things. He was interested in getting the magnificent horses, whereas Bassanio is motivated by love. Therefore, Bassanio is greater than Hercules. That is where we stopped. Today we shall look at Act 3, Scene 2, verses 65 to 90. First we look at verses 65 to 74, where the music or the song is being played. What is the purpose of playing this song? The purpose is to lighten the atmosphere. The tensed atmosphere has to be lightened. That is the purpose. What is the message of the song? Fancy versus true love. What is fancy? That's a key word in the song. Fancy is passing affection. Passing affection is temporary affection. Where is fancy bred? Where is fancy born? False love, passing affection, where is it born? How it is being nurtured? Is it born in the head or in the heart? And the song concludes saying, fancy, that is passing affection, is born in the eyes. Just because you are beholding something, you are seeing something, because of the appearance you are attracted, infatuated. That is fancy. Just opposite of that is true love. True love is born in the heart and is nurtured in the heart, and it stands forever. So indirectly the song is giving a message, saying the choice of casket should be made based not on the outside appearance, but what is inside. At the end of the song, Portia says, "Let us all ding dong bell." Let's all sing ding dong bell. That is bidding goodbye to false love and welcoming true love. This song being played before the choice has raised a lot of criticism from many, saying that favoritism has been shown by Portia to Bassanio, because earlier in Act 2, Scene 7, Prince of Morocco made the choice. There was no music. Again in Act 2, Scene 9, when Prince of Aragon made the choice, there was no song. Whereas when Bassani is about to make the choice, music was being played. Did Portia give a hint to Bassanio which casket to choose? But critics say this kind of allegation is not true, because Bassanio was busy. He was worried about which casket to choose. He was preoccupied with the selection of the casket. He would not have even heard the music. Therefore, it is not true. And once again, Portia, being a noble woman, a woman of great values, she will not break the oath she made to her daddy. Therefore, this allegation need not be true. Now we shall go to the next part. Scene 2, verses 75 onwards. We are going to do 75 to 90. So from 75 to 90 verses, and in the later also, the catchy word or the central word is ornaments. Ornaments. Ornaments means outward shows. You know, women like ornaments, especially when they go out for a marriage function. They like to display a lot of ornaments for everyone to see. So it is being displayed, being shown, so that people can see outside appearance. Ornaments stands for outside appearance. Outside appearance is one thing. What is inside is something else. Therefore, ornament is the catchy word. And it said that the world is deceived with ornament. The world means the people is deceived, is being cheated. People are being cheated by outward appearance. But what is inside is more important than the author gives a few examples. He says, vice is in the form of virtue. Vice is in the form of virtue. Vice is evil or bad things. Virtue is good or goodness. So evil and goodness, vice, evil is hidden. And what is outside seen is virtue. Virtue is displayed outside, and bad things are hidden inside. Few examples: in law, in religion, and then he speaks about cowards. In law. In law is court of law. What it matters is eloquence. Eloquence is your ability to talk well and convince others. Even the one who has done corruption, one who has done wrong, is justified by the advocate who has the eloquence to speak, the ability to speak so well and convince the judge. So what is seen is outside his talent, but inside he is defending a corrupt person. Then in religion, pious look and holy text. Pious look and holy text. In religion, there are so many bad things happening, but they are all covered up by the pious look, good looking person. Maybe the priest or pujari, whoever it may be. And with the help of the holy text, That is, the Holy Scripture is being quoted in order to hide the evil things. So, wise in the form of virtue, evil in the form of goodness. Then comes cowards. Cowards are people who are frightened, fearful people. In order to hide their fearfulness, their fright, they put on the show. They give the appearance of something else. You are a species of false gods, a stars of sand, stairs of sand. False arts are stairs of sand. They have false arts are stairs of sand. What is stairs of sand? Stairs is staircase. Staircase built of sand. What is the problem with it? They are unreliable. Very important point. Stairs built of sand are unreliable. They are not strong. If stairs are built of stone, if they are built for today's contest, if they are built in concrete with the cement and sand, then it is strong. But just built with sand alone, they are unreliable. Similarly, these cupboards are also unreliable. Why? They were the gates of Hercules and Mars. It is said that beard of Hercules and frowns of Mars. Who were Hercules and Mars? Hercules was the god of strength and Mars was the god of war. God of strength was Hercules. God of war was Mars. Hercules is always identified with his beard and Mars is always identified with his frowning face. So these cowards, they wear the look of Hercules and Mars either by putting up a beard or giving a frowning face in order to show that they are courageous. This is only outward appearance. If you go deeper, if you go inside, then you find something else. Inward, they are cowards. Externally, they are valor. Signs of valor and courage. So he says, if you go inside, you find they have livid white as milk. Elizabeth then believed that liver is a seat of courage. Which is the seat of courage for us? Yes, it's a heart. It's heart. Courageous heart. Brave heart. Have you seen the movie Brave Hearts? A heart which is brave is that of a courageous man. But in those days, in Elizabethan time, they believed that liver was the seat of courage, and a liver which is pale or white as milk meant that they were cowards. And if they had a liver which is red, full of blood, it meant that they were courageous. That's why it is said, outwardly they look like courageous people, but when you go inside, you will find they have hearts, livers of milk. That is, they were not courageous, they were cowards. Before I conclude, may I request you to do some homework. We have been attending the classes, but you haven't done any homework. You'll have to do the workbook homework. Your workbook, page number 156 to 159. Question numbers 1 and 2. This is workbook. In your workbook, page number 156 to 159, there are so many, a series of questions. You do question number 1 and 2. Thank you.